As you wish. This is a dangerous area. Look out! As you wish. As you wish. As you wish. As you wish.
I found your bow.
And in one piece! Thank you! This is much better than anything I could have made. I can hunt again. Thank you, thank you!
Who said you could give Leonard his bow?
He needed it, so I got it for him.
You might think you were being helpful, but that wasn't. Leonard needed to learn a lesson. How's he gonna do that now?
About the raptors. Those raptors are dead meat.
We can get back to hunting again now. Well, I take my words back. You have proved yourself. Maybe I have grown too cynical in my time out here. I certainly didn't expect you to survive, let alone kill those raptors.
Is that all you want from life?
What else is there? Hunting, fresh air, and... Well, Goliath does have one thing to offer that can't be found here.
What is that?
Beer. I can't remember the last time I had one. Beer is the only thing missing from life.
Here, you can have this one.
You'd give me a beer? What's the catch?
No catch. You look like you need a beer.
I did underestimate you.
What do you have to trade?
That was well done. We could learn much from these ruins. I would have liked to see the old world as it was before the comet.
You're a good man. Thanks again.
Where the clerics and elves use Elex, the berserkers have solved their problems by using nature. Isn't that fascinating?
What elevator?
What elevator? The enormous wheel over there, the winch down to the world of exile.
What do you do here, apart from shout at passersby?
You watch your mouth. I'm the sole sentinel here. I do the guarding and the repairing. More the guarding than repairing right now. The elevator is bust and no one showed me how to fix it. So unless you know anything about winches, you can't get down there. Do you know anything about winches?
Enough to know it can't be complicated to fix.
What makes you think that?
It's a winch. Rope, wheel, up and down. What's so complicated about that?
It's a water winch. It needs water. And gears. It's complicated stuff. Fixing this elevator is really complicated, seeing as one of the gears is missing. So unless you've got a portable smelter and forge to make a new one, you're not gonna be repairing it right now, are you?
That depends.
Yeah?
Have you got a spare part?
Spare part? Spare part? Now, why didn't I think of that? Wait, yeah. I got loads of parts for you, right here. In my pants.
It's your job. Why don't you go and fetch a spare part?
Because my job has two parts, right? Guarding and repairing. Right now, there's only one part of my job that I'm not doing. If I go off looking for things, then I won't be doing either part of my job. And I don't want to get exiled for dereliction of duty.
How long has the gear been missing?
Since the other night. But why do you care? It's gone, and that's it.
It was stolen?
Exactly.
Even though you are supposed to be guarding the elevator?
It could be that I left my post for a short while.
So, you weren't guarding the elevator, and now you're not repairing it?
Clever, yeah, very clever. Look, the part's gone, and that's it. Now I'm back at my post, and, you know, maybe someone took the gear for maintenance or something.
But aren't you the person responsible for maintenance?
You know what? Fuck it. I took the winch apart and got rid of the gear. Satisfied?
You wanted to sabotage it?
I don't want anyone to leave the valley. And be honest, neither do you. Do you think it's right that they, those criminals, get to go home for good service? While good people like me get stuck here without a chance for parole? Fuck that. Fuck them. They got themselves sent down there. They can stay down there.
You're going to tell me how I can get the gear back?
Yeah, good luck with that. I dropped it down the waterfall. With any luck, no one will find it.
So, it's by the waterfall. Thanks.
Shit, I knew. Soon as I saw you, I knew that this day was gonna be a ball ache.
I'll find the missing gear.
I don't want it found.
Excellent. Are you sure this is a good place for us to be?
Not now.
As you wish.
Not now. That depends.
Yeah?
I've got the missing gear, so now you can repair the winch.
Are you sure you want that doing? Think about it. You're opening the door to criminals. We could be attacked, murdered, passed over for promotion. Who knows what could happen?
I'm not asking. Fix the damn winch.
So, your mind can't be changed? All right. I will, under one condition. Give me your word, man to man, that you will keep your silence. Ragnar can't find out that I sabotaged his elevator. All right?
I'm not promising you anything.
Look, you've got what you want. Don't push me. You don't need to go telling anyone anything.
I'm going to do what I want.
Not if I shut your mouth first. So, I'm gonna shut it. I will kill you!
Judging by the structure of this box and the hoses attached to it, this seems to have once been some sort of primitive food release system. People probably held their plates under the hoses to receive their portion of protein porridge. I wonder what it tasted like. The desert. Our present and our past blown together on the wind. Philosophy is a much neglected area of study. The old world had more time for it, so my research has shown.
Maybe if they'd spent more time on science, the comet wouldn't have hit.
Maybe. Or perhaps knowing who they were helped people to survive what happened. We'll never know.
I'll save you the trouble of looking around. This place has already been picked clean. So don't waste your time here. You'll do better elsewhere.
You just want to get rid of me.
Hey, I'm just trying to save you some time. Sure, have a look around. See what you find. But I'm telling you, you're wasting your time. This place is cleaned out. Here, take some water. You might as well not go home completely empty-handed. And don't worry, it's clean. Any animal that tries to piss in the well here ends up fried. Right, enough with the talk. I need to feed my mutt.
When are you moving on?
Ah, that can wait. My boots are rubbing. I could use a little break.
How did you train that jackal?
I didn't. Someone else did. When I found him, he was chewing on a sword. Either his owner had abandoned him, or had been killed. In any case, he's harmless. Not like the other beasts around here. That's why I decided to take him with me. Big daft oaf that he is.
Do you have anything to sell?
Sell? No. I'm no good as a trader. I tried it once, but in the end, just brought me trouble. Guys who couldn't pay. Guys who bargained over every last shard. I don't want to deal with that sort of shit.
So there's nothing you want to trade?
Well, if you can get some raw meat, I'll trade you something. Snuffles over there could do with something better to eat than old shoe soles.
Sure, I'll get you some meat.
Okay. A half dozen cuts should be enough.
That was remarkable.
Thank you. damn beast!
As you wish.
Hey, you! Where do you think you're going? This is a restricted area, and you have no business here.
It doesn't look like a restricted area.
What? You want me to build you a fence? Dig you a moat? Put out some nice shiny signs? It's restricted because I say it's restricted.
Why is this area restricted?
Did I say restricted? Man, I've been out here too long. I meant it's as dangerous as trying to hold a barbecue in the Ice Palace. There are mutants all over the place, just waiting for you. I'd head up into our camp, or better still, just get out of here if you don't want to end up as mutant food.
Your camp could use better defenses.
We've done what we can. You want to help us? You go for it.
There are mutants everywhere on Magellan.
Yeah, but the ones here are right mean bastards. And no matter how many of them you kill, they keep coming back. There are at least 10 round here right now. They're out there, waiting in ambush somewhere.
The mutants are dead.
What, all of them? They're all gone?
All the ones I could find.
Shit. That's a load off. I didn't realize how tense I was, but I can breathe again now. Here, take this for your help. I'm heading back into Origin. You can come with me if you want. We could use people like you.
Teach me something.
Yeah, okay.
Who's in charge here?
Lloyd. He's the most experienced warrior among us. He calls our little camp up here Origin. I never really understood what that means. If you want to talk to him about it, he's up there in the camp.
too easy.
Hey, you! Where do you think you're going?
Who are you?
Another one of them, are you? You think you can wander in here and start asking questions and demanding things, do you? Well, you'd better keep your weapon sheathed and your hands to yourself. That way we won't have any trouble with each other, okay?
What is this place?
It's a refuge. The last refuge from the Alp converters for many. For others, it is a stronghold of freedom. For me, it is my mission in life. Everyone looking for protection will find it here with us. That is my promise. You, however, don't look like you need protection. So, that makes me wonder. If you're not here seeking refuge, what are you looking for?
What do you do here?
I take care of Origin's defenses. If you believe in a dream, you have to protect it.
And how is that job going?
Why the interest in our defenses? Who sent you?
I'm just making conversation.
Conversation? And it just happens to be about our defenses. Don't think you can get around me that easily, asshole.
If I really wanted information, I could beat it out of you.
Oh yeah? You think? I'll show you, you fucking spy.
But all it is chemistry, exploitation, and a lonely death. Only Kalan knows the way to salvation.
That was a strange choice.
What else do you want here? Haven't you caused enough trouble?
I want to start over. We got off on the wrong foot. Let's forget about the past, all right?
Easy to say. You better not try that shit again.
What can I do to help people here?
You really want to do that? Well, we can always do with more weapons. But above all, we need more people. Experienced people to help defend this place.
So you want me to find people with combat skills for you?
Exactly. People you can rely on. Loyal people you can trust. Farmers and refugees here, they do their best. We need some real fighters. People who've been out in the wilderness and survived. If you meet anyone out there you'd trust to watch your back, who'd fight alongside you, well, I guess you can tell them where we are and that they'd be welcome here in Origin.
If I find anyone I can trust, I'll send them here.
You will? Okay, then. All right. It'll be good to have some more companions out here who understand what they're doing. At least three would help. That would make good our losses.
Ray, an outlaw, has agreed to help. He'll be useful, just don't leave anything shiny around when he's nearby.
As if we didn't have enough crooks in camp already. So just know you're responsible for him and anything he takes. That's good for a start. Who else can you offer?
I met Duras, a berserker warrior. He's agreed to travel with me, and we'll stay here in between.
Good. Great. The berserkers know how to defend themselves. Have you found anyone else?
Falk, cleric has agreed to help me. He will stay to defend Origin when he's not with me.
A cleric? Well, we'll see if he's prepared to do the fighting himself, not just leave it to others. Okay. I would say that's enough fighters to make our camp safe. I mean, any more would be welcome, but you've taken the pressure off us for now. I just hope they can work together. We can do without arguments here. But I suppose we'll find out when the next mutant attack comes.
How did you end up here?
Me? I used to be a guard in the Domed City. Then I got sent to the front during one of the Alb attacks that were happening back then. We were told we were going there to help the farmers. We got no mercy from the Albs, and we gave none back. And the people trapped between us? I don't know how they survived. And after it was done and all those bodies were piled up, we turned around and went straight back to the city and just left those people out here to fend for themselves. That didn't seem right to me. So when I heard rumors about Origin and the help it offered people, well, I came here to find something that was actually worth fighting for.
Who are you? Are you in charge here?
Me? No. That's Lloyd. He's the only one crazy enough to try and keep this place together. But don't go bothering him with small stuff. He has better things to do than waste his time on strays.
I have things to do.
Just one seed of hope can grow a whole world. Welcome to Origin, stranger. I am Lloyd, spiritual father and leader of the people here.
And who are the people here?
Threatened by the storm from the north. We keep watch with pride and confidence. Let your weapons rest and draw new strength from our fire and our company. We are here to provide an alternative. We are here to hold back the Alps, but without all the lies that come with the great factions.
You think you can hold back the Alps on your own? Sounds rather naive for this small group of free people.
Great vision is always ridiculed. War is like every game. The points are only really counted at the end.
The war is just a game to you?
No. But life is always easier when you know the rules of your opponent.
Tell me about your vision.
I have seen this world in all its broken glory. I have seen that the different factions that have risen since the Great Catastrophe all have one thing in common. They are all prisoners to their laws. They are all prisoners of their past. But amongst all of those factions are people who have seen this for themselves. And this camp is their point of contact.
You are fighting for the free people?
We fight for freedom and self-determination. We defy the oppressors and all those who blindly follow them. One day there will come a person, someone in our midst who can change the world from its very foundations up. And I believe that that person has come to us here and now today.
You think I'm the person who can change the world?
Let's drop this foolish masquerade. We both know who we are talking about, Commander.
And who do you think I am?
You are Jax, Alb Commander. He who left Zaykor, who was said to be dead but is risen. You lost the power of the past, but you didn't crumble. Oh no. For here in front of me, I see here an upright, strong person and his internal conflict between human and machine. Who, if not you, could really make a difference? You who straddles the worlds of Zaykor and the Free People, of life and death.
I didn't rise from the dead. I narrowly escaped execution.
Modesty and ability together in one person. You will be more than a figurehead. You will be a leader.
You offer people shelter here?
People? Yes. That is the point. We are all people. Whatever labels we have put upon us, The domed city is a shelter for those who want a new start, but who cling to their old past. Here, all people give up on their belief of the past to build a new future for themselves. So, to win their trust, show them that you believe that too. That you look forward, not back.
What do I have to do to be allowed to stay here?
Fit in. If the people like you, then you will have a place to stay here.
Who do I have to prove myself to?
Well, start with those with the most influence. That will persuade the others. There's our scout, our guard, Jonesy. He helps protect us from the local mutants. Then, there's Eckhart. He is responsible for the overall defense of this place. And of course, Harley, our mechanic. You can probably make him happy if you bring him something interesting to repair. They are good men, and they are waiting for a leader.
How do you defend this place?
A number of experienced, expert fighters have come to our cause. Enough to keep back the mutants and the Alb patrols.
Your Capmaster Eckhart is a very determined man.
Yes, that he is. But I'm glad that he is here. Without his skills, we would have been overrun by mutants long ago. Winning him over to your side shows you are the person I thought you were. That is excellent progress.
Your scout Jonesy is very committed.
We all owe him our lives. His dedication has kept Origin safe. It's good that you helped him. He knows now that he has your support. You're making good progress.
I helped Eckhart secure the camp.
Very good. I've already met your companions. You made some interesting choices. But somehow they fit in with the rest of the group here. You've done well. I look forward to hearing more of your exploits.
We've got rid of the mutants in the surrounding area.
Well, you've bought us some time. Nature abhors a vacuum, and other mutants will come. But Origin is safer for the death of those creatures. There are still some things to do, and I'm sure that you'll complete those tasks as well.
No. No. Too easy.
I must remember this place.
Needs a key.
Whatever you want fixing, stick it over there. There's a waiting list, and I got a lot of shit to mend.
That jackal over there, is that your pet?
I have no idea where that thing came from. Just turned up here one day. Scared the living shit out of me, to be honest. But it doesn't seem so bad now. It hasn't tried to eat anyone or anything, so, you know, as long as it doesn't take a shit on my tools, it's fine to stay.
You're a mechanic?
Yeah, Harley. Deputy foreman of the 4th work crew from the Horde of Ignodon. Or I was. Now I'm senior foreman of the only fucking guy here. The Horde's days are over, buddy. We are all real free people out here. So if you want to have something repaired, you will have to pay for it.
So, you're a cleric?
Was. I was trained in the Horde. But I never got into all the religious stuff. So it's been good to find a way to keep doing what I do without the need for all that praising and believing. Although I did get to play around with some more interesting machinery back in the Horde.
What sort of things can you fix?
What do you need fixing? Chances are, whatever it is, I can sort it out for you. Chances are I can fix it upside down while under fire in a combat zone. Meaning, it'll be a piece of cake to fix it here. What I wouldn't give for a real challenge. A mech, a raider, anything with real technical expertise involved.
How much experience do you have with flyers?
Flyers? You mean jetpacks? What model are we talking about?
I had something bigger than jetpacks in mind.
Bigger? Well, the only thing that's bigger these days is an Alb Raider. What? Is that what you're talking about?
Yeah.
Well, I don't know how you'll get your hands on one of them. Unless you're talking about the one that came down in Edan. If it is, you better be fast. I've heard people are looking for that sucker.
Could you get hold of that Alb Raider?
Yeah, well, I might have an idea where it is. Okay, all right. I was hardly able to keep myself together when that thing went down. I mean, I had to see it. I told myself, this is my chance to see one of those things up close. So, I got by the Berserker patrols in Edan, and went up to the old observatory and had a closer look at it. The thing was a bit of a wreck. It had hit the mountain further up and then came down the side of it.
Do you think you can repair it?
Not out there in the mountains, no. But if the engine was still intact, then I suppose someone might be able to fly it here. Then I could really have a go at getting it working.
Can you repair the engine?
Well, I would need a high-capacity hydraulic conductor to get it back in order. And you don't just find something like that lying around. I suppose you could get one from another raider, but I've got no idea how you're going to do that. Or, well, yeah, you could bring down one of those fighting colossi from the 7300 series. They also have one of those high-capacity conductors installed in them. So, well, I suppose we should forget about it then. I mean, it's not impossible to get one, but it might as well be, huh?
If I get you the conductor, can you repair the engine?
Yeah, good joke. What? You're serious?
I can get the conductor from a fighting colossus from the 7300 series.
You really think you can bring one of those down? Well, okay, listen. There might be one you could take down a little easier than the full-strength ones. You see, I heard one went rogue due to a faulty control unit. It's still active somewhere in the southern mountains of Ignodon. But even though it's faulty, you'd have to be nuts to try and take it on.
A tame jackal? I've never met one like this before. No. Too easy. Oh.
Origin's defenses must hold.
Hi, I'm Annie. Are you here to make a donation? Every shard you can give will go into building up our little community here.
Yeah, I'll make a donation.
That is great. I'm glad to hear that. You'll have our gratitude. You can be sure that everything you give will go to helping people. And if you like, you can even donate to a specific cause. We are hoping to make the place look better and to get the equipment we need, you know, workbenches and things like that. Let me know what you think would be helpful. I will take care of it. So, what'll it be?
I would like to donate shards to the camp.
No problem. What would you like to build?
Dangerous times. Travel safely.
What goods have you got?
Yes, of course.
Ugh!